I am Vandana and you are watching 99.9 Engineering Station. So student, in today's lecture, I am going to discuss with you a newly added topic in the subject mass transfer, and the topic is membrane separation. So basically, the theory part of the membrane separation is already covered in my previous lecture. The link of the previous lectures are given in the description box and in the I button. So you can go and watch it once, okay? So today's lecture is basically or mainly dedicated towards the microfiltration. As we all know that the microfiltration play a very important role in the membrane separation parts, okay? So in today's lecture, we are going to discuss the microfiltration objectives, formula used to calculate the solvent flux, and the numerical based upon the solvent flux calculation. So without further ado, let's get started with the video. But before that, if you have not subscribed to my channel, subscribe it. Otherwise, you will not get any type of notification from my side. And one more important thing is that you have to follow me on Telegram, and because in Telegram I used to post many important questions, numerical, PDF, short notes, notes and many more things. So follow me there and subscribe my YouTube channel. So without further ado, let's get started with the lecture and the topic. So as we know that the microfiltration play a very important role in the membrane separation operation. Okay, so if we discuss the objective of the microfiltration, that is to concentrate the suspension by forcing the liquid through the pores of the membrane. It means we have to force the suspendent concentrated liquid through the pores of the membrane. Okay, so this is the objective. So we have to calculate, the main thing is that we have to calculate the solvent flux. Okay, we have to calculate the solvent flux. And how we calculate the solvent flux? By using the number of equations. So the first one is the by Darcy equation. So let's discuss the Darcy equation, that is equal to JW is equal to K dash delta P. JW is equal to K dash delta P, or you can also write it as LP delta P. Okay, so here delta P is the applied pressure driving force and K is the constant. Okay, K is the constant, which is same as the water permeability, which is same as the water permeability LP. Water permeability is represented by the LP. That's why we replace this equation, or you can also write this equation as JW is equal to LP delta P. Okay, and its value depends upon the difference value of the membrane parameters like porosity, torticity, pore size distribution, liquid density, viscosity. All these are depends upon these parameters. Okay, so formula which is used for calculating the solvent flux by the Darcy equation is JW is equal to LP delta P. Okay, that's it. Okay, now what happens if the flow in the pore is laminar? Then what will happen and which type of equation we can use with that for calculating the solvent pores is the Heisen-Posley equation. We calculate the solvent flux by the Heisen-Posley equation, and that is equal to sigma d square upon 32 mu tau into delta P upon Lm. Okay, and we can also replace this equation some constant by the resistance, flow resistance, and we can write it as a delta P mu Rm. It means we replace which parameters? We replace Rm by 32 tau Lm by sigma d square. We replace sigma d square 32 mu or and mu, sorry, mu not mu, tau and Lm. We replace it by Rm. We give them a name Rm, and we reduce this equation into a JW is equal to delta P mu Rm. Okay, that's it. So we can, if the flow is laminar, we use to calculate the solvent flux with this equation, which is equation number 2. We consider this one is the equation number 1 and this one is the equation number 2. Now the another important thing is that what will happen or what type of flux we use for calculating when the membrane contains some type of void spaces, then in that case we consider it as a packed bed. In that case we calculate the JW, that is solvent flux, with a formula, or we can formula by Corzine-Karman equation. By what was that? That is JW is equal to ds square sigma square upon 180 mu 1 minus sigma to power to whole 1 minus sigma to power square delta p upon lm. So this is the equation when we consider the void spaces, and we can say that the membrane is behave like a packed bed, then only we use this type of equation. Now discuss the what are the parameter notifications, that how we can identify the which parameter indicate what thing. So here the sigma represent the membrane porosity. Sigma is basically a membrane porosity. D is the pore diameter. T is the tauticity of the pore, and lm is the membrane thickness, and mu is the liquid viscosity, and liquid viscosity, and delta p is the applied pressure driving force, and rm is the flow resistance. Okay, and ds is the equivalent particle diameter. So this is all about the all the formulas of for calculating the solvent flux. Based upon the given condition, you can apply this equation and solve it by once. You can solve the various thing from this equation, like you can calculate the liquid of solvent flux, or you can also calculate the resistance, and or you can also calculate from this equation by membrane thickness or viscosity if the given condition is asking upon that condition. Okay, so now we are going to move to solve some numerical which is based upon these equations. So let's get start. So let's discuss the numerical first. Okay, so the statement for the numerical is 75 micrometer thick polysulfone microporous membrane has an average porosity of sigma is equal to 0.35. we have a microfiltration, that is polysulfone microporous membrane, and its average porosity is given in terms of constant, that is 0.35. okay, so the pure water flux through the membrane is 75 meter cube per meter square hour at a pressure drop of 1.2 bar at 25 degrees Celsius. Okay, so the average pore size is given, that 1 micrometer, and we have to calculate the torticity factors of the pore, resistance to flow, and the water permeability. And the given data also we have that the viscosity of water at a 25 degrees Celsius is 0.9 cp. So we have to find out three things, that is toricity factors, resistance to flow, and water permeability. Okay, so for before going to calculating or write down the formula, first we write out the given parameter and convert into a proper unit. Okay, so as given in the question, that average pore size is given, that is 1 micrometer. So we have to convert first 1 micrometer into a meter. So for converting it, we simply multiply with a 10 to power minus 6, and then we get the average pore size in meter, that is 1 into 10 to power minus 6 meter. Now another thing is given, that is pressure difference, that is 1.2 bar. So we have to convert into a Pascal. For converting into a Pascal, we simply multiply with a 10 to power 5 Pascal. Okay, and another thing is viscosity, given that is 0.9 cp. So we have to convert into a kg per meter second. For that we have to multiply it with 10 to power minus 4 kg per meter second. Okay, so another is lm is given, the thickness of the membrane, it is given as 75 micrometer. So we simply multiply it with the 10 to power minus 6 meter. Another data is sigma is equal to 0.35 and JW, flux is given, that is 25 meter cube per meter square per hour. So we have to convert into a 25 upon 3600 meter cube per meter square per second. Okay, so flux is in this terms. So for calculating the parameters, torticity factor, resistance flow and the water permeability, first we have to check that the flow is laminar or another thing. So for calculating the laminarity, we need the form of what we need: viscosity, diameter, diameter, density and the velocity. Okay, so the density, viscosity is 25 upon viscosity is already given, that is 0.9 into 10 to power minus 4, and the velocity is calculated from this flux, that is 25 upon 36600 meter per second, and the density of the water is 998 kg per meter. Now we have all the data for calculating the Reynolds number. So we have to simply put all the data in the Reynolds number formula and then check that the flow is laminar or not. So let's do that. Reynolds number is equal to D is given, that 10 to power minus 6, U is 25 upon 3600 and the rho is 998 upon mu is 0.9 into 10 to power minus 4, and from here the Reynolds number we get, that is 7.7 into 10 to power minus 3. Okay, 7.7 into 10 to power minus 3, it means it is come under the range of laminar flow. It means definitely it is a laminar flow into a pore membrane. So it means we have to calculate the flux through the Heisen-Posley equation, which is equal to JW is equal to sigma D square upon 32 mu L mu tau delta P upon LM. So first we have to calculate the torticity factor. It means we have to calculate the tau. Okay, so just put all the values. We have a sigma value, D value, delta P value, 32, viscosity in LM, all the value we have JW value. So simply substitute all the value and we get from here tau is equal to, we get from here tau is equal to 2.8. torticity factor we get from here, that is 2.8. next we have to calculate the resistance of flow. For calculating the resistance for flow, we simplify this equation into a this equation. By simplify this equation into a which equation, we simplify this equation into a delta P upon mu Rm, where Rm is 32 mu tau upon sigma d square ये था और हमें कैलकुलेट करना है रेजिस्टेंस. तो हम कैसे कैलकुलेट करेंगे, हमें JW पता है, डेल्टा P पता है और वी ऑल्सो नो द विस्कोसिटी. वी सिंपली रीअरेंज दिस इक्वेशन लाइक दैट इनटू म्यू अपॉन डेल्टा P एंड वी गेट यहाँ फ्रॉम हेयर Rm इज इक्वल टू 1.9 1.92 into 10 to power 10 to power 10 meter inverse. Okay, meter inverse. We calculate this from here. Now the last term is the water permeability, that is the LP. That is LP, or LP is calculated with a Darcy equation, that is JW is equal to LP delta P. Kisho chuna nahi. We calculate the LP by, so we calculate the LP by the Darcy equation, that is JW is equal to LP delta T. We know the JW, we know delta P, and it means we simply dividing JW with delta P, we get the LP value, that is water permeability, and it is equal to 5.79 into 10 to power minus 8 into 10 to power minus 8 meter cube per meter square second Pascal. Okay, so that's how we calculate the all the parameters like resistance, torticity factor, water permeability, thickness, and the flux by these three formulas only. So this is very simple. I think you understand the all the concept of microfiltration. In the next lecture, I'm going to discuss the MCQ and MSQ question about the microfiltration. How, which type of question will ask in GATE 2021. So till then, if you understand everything, so please share this video to the maximum so that others can also take advantage of it. Till then, thank you and have a nice day.